there's also an integrated terminal window, and the integrated terminal window can be viewed by clicking on View and then Terminal. And so now what you have a terminal, you can see it's actually a command terminal. So this would be identical to coming down here and typing CMD and choosing command prompt. If you want to have PowerShell, there's a couple of options. There's an integrated PowerShell. This is a preview and I've had some issues with it. So instead of using that, I'm just going to type in PowerShell. And so now that takes me into PowerShell. So you can see that it changed the kernel this is associated with. So what I'm going to use PowerShell, and I'm going to invoke this particular PowerShell command. This happens to run an SQL command, but I want to do this in PowerShell, and you'll see why in just a minute. So I'm going to go ahead and pick that up and pop that down in the terminal window, and I'll run this PowerShell command. This PowerShell command has gone into my default database, looked at information schema on the local host for ELTSnap v2. We'll talk more about ELTSnap v2. That's our extract, load, and transform data integration product, which is more or less a case study for the application that we'll be using in the integration into Azure Data Studio. So that's all well and good, but I could have done this just within the notebook or SQL window. But what if you wanted to create an HTML file from this? To do that, you would just pipe the results of this out to, so in PowerShell, that vertical bar is a pipe. You take this output, convert it to HTML, and then place that into a table called tablelist.htm. So I'll pick that up and pop that in. Okay, so that now has run. To see the results, I can invoke the item, and $$ is a system variable in PowerShell to get you the last variable, which would have been this table. So I'll go ahead and just paste that in, and there we go. This is the HTML table that we just created that is listing the database, the schema, the table name, etc. It could use some styling, CSS, but it works pretty well.